is Jade at Inspirlang. A lot of our students have been asking me how to install a Cantonese typing or input method into their computers or phones. So in this tutorial, we will show you the step-by-step process of how to install a Cantonese input source to Mac and iOS devices. We have a blog already that gives a step-by-step guide to install the input source, and resources are also provided. So we're going to first head over to our Inspirlang website. Go to blog and click on Editor's Insights. Our Editor's Insights blog provides many resources and interesting reads that you can check out. Look for How to Type Cantonese, Install Input Methods. We also have a guide to install Mandarin as an input source, but today we will focus on Cantonese. In this blog, we have the input installation guide for Mac, Windows 10, iOS, and Android. This video is only going to focus on Mac and iOS. Make sure you have the most updated iOS system, and then click System Preferences from your desktop, and then maneuver to keyboard on your right sidebar. Under Text Input, click Edit and add Cantonese, but make sure that you are adding the one that says phonetic. Click Add. And you're done. How do you make sure that you have it already? Go to your top bar and check. Your input method is stored right there. If you want to check it out and test it out with a document, feel free to start typing in Cantonese, but make sure that you click on the enabling Cantonese you paint first. And as you're typing in Cantonese, you might have realized that you don't actually have to type character by character. You can type in popular phrases and also words that are made up of many different characters. Next, we have the iOS version. The newest version has a built-in Cantonese YouPaint input. Woohoo! You just have to go to Settings, go to General, then go to Keyboard, then into Keyboards. Click on Add New Keyboard and then search for Cantonese Traditional. Click into it and choose Phonetic. Then click Done. Now you can type YouPaint on your phone. We can test it out. As you can see, installing the input source is not hard. However, typing Cantonese will require you to know YouPaint. If you're interested in learning or improving your YouPaint, then go visit our content, links in the description below. That will teach you the basics you need to know. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye! 하치긴! Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe if you like my video. If you would like more Chinese learning contents from me, please visit inspirlang.com for more. I hope to see you again in my next video. Bye bye!